Hi everybody, we have an allocation video for you today. This video is all about a litter of mini Labradoodles and finding out which family is going to be taking home which of these Labradoodle puppies. Hi, I'm Claire from Van Isle Doodles. Next to pickup day, this is the most exciting day for our families. They've waited a long time to find out which one of these adorable little mini Labradoodle puppies is going to be their very own and go home with them in just a very short period of time. So we're going to go through each of these little Labradoodle puppies. They're all mini Labradoodles, although one's going to kind of surprise you by his looks in terms of being a mini Labradoodle. And we're going to give you a little bit of a synopsis about what each family was looking for in their new Labradoodle puppy and what each of these Labradoodles puppies are like. Now, one thing we want everyone to remember, when we do these videos and assign our Labradoodle puppies to our families, and when you take your little Labradoodle puppy home with you, this is just a snapshot. They're very young still, and their personalities still change quite rapidly. And once your Labradoodle puppy is home with you, they begin to mirror you and your environment. So sometimes you'll see a little bit of a change in the temperament and personality of these little Labradoodles, and that's just because they're mirroring what you are providing to them. These little Labradoodle puppies are like sponges. They absorb everything. So the way that you treat them and the atmosphere in your home is what they're going to internalize and then in turn project back to you. So just remember that, because you want to have a nice, calm, happy environment so that your Labradoodle puppy stays a nice, calm, happy Labradoodle puppy, right? All right, so we're going to do the puppies in birth order. And there's only four puppies in this litter, so this is not going to be an extraordinarily long video. We will do a pickup Zoom meeting for all of our families who are getting one of these mini Labradoodles a little later, and so we won't bore you with anything and make you wait any longer. So this is Brown Collar Boy. Brown Collar Boy is the first mini Labradoodle puppy born in the first Noel litter. And this little guy is a caramel. And Brown Collar Boy is going to be going to live with Arlene and Daryl in Courtney. He's going to live in the beautiful Comox Valley, just a gorgeous area for a little Labradoodle puppy to grow up in. Now, Daryl and Arlene were looking for a companion. They've been used to always having a dog, and when they lost their last beloved dog, they were all feeling like their home was not quite full without having a puppy in it. They have a very active lifestyle. They have a pool and they enjoy boating, and they also wanted a puppy who was going to be really good in the car for traveling and who knew how to be quiet when Daddy is working and on Zoom meetings. So Mr. Brown, we chose him for Daryl and Arlene because he is an extraordinarily calm and quiet dog. You'll see as he's sitting here, he's quite content just to sit here quietly, mind his own business. He's not too nosy. He doesn't require me constantly touching him, paying attention to him. He's a very gentle boy, just an incredibly soft, soft touch of a fellow. You'll see he has extraordinarily good eye contact. He's always checking in with me, but he's also independent enough that he's focused outwards too, where he doesn't feel he has to always be checking in and seeing what I say, but he does keep tabs on me. And this is how Brown Collar is when he's outside. When he's outside exploring and having an adventure, he's off doing his own thing, and then he'll turn back, check, make sure that the humans are nearby and that he hasn't made a mistake and gone too far away, or that they aren't heading off in a direction that he needs to be aware of. This little guy is full of cuddles and snuggles. He likes nothing better than to be held, to have his chest rubbed, and just to be told what a good, good boy you are. What a good puppy you are. Yes, he just loves that. You can see him just easing right into me, cuddling up with me, and getting a very soft eye when I give him that nice goo-goo gaga thing. And, oh, I'm probably going to get a kiss. Thank you for the kisses. He is a very affectionate fellow. And this is a puppy who will really enjoy outdoor life and being active with Daryl and Arlene. He really loves to go outside. He scampers around all over the place. He's constantly looking for new things, love to try out the slide. And I think he'll probably really enjoy the boat. He's the type of puppy with the type of personality that when you are boating, you don't have to worry about him running all over the boat and falling overboard. He'll just sit there next to you and watch and see what's going on in the world. And I suspect he's probably going to grow up to really enjoy having a pool. I wish I had a pool, but I'm pretty sure that when it comes to summer, he'll be right in there like a dirty shirt. Certainly his Mama Ripple and his Grandma Peanut, they adore water and they are always in the water at the beach. So I suspect Mr. Brown Collar will be too. So that's our little mini Labradoodle Brown Collar boy off to Courtney with Daryl and Arlene. And now, after Brown Collar, we have Black Collar, who looks just like a twin practically to his brother Brown. He wanted to turn around and show everybody your beautiful face. He too is a gorgeous caramel puppy, and he is just a little tiny bit bigger than Brown Collar, not enough to make a big difference. And Black Collar Boy is going to be going to live with Robin, Stephen, Sydney, and Brixton in Burnaby. This family was looking for a true family dog, a good companion, and some security for Robin. Sometimes when Stephen is working different hours, she's home alone, and it's always so comforting to have a dog there with you by your side. Lots of really good company. They wanted also a puppy who was going to be able to stay calm in the storm that two kids can sometimes create. An intuitive dog who was affectionate and confident. Black Collar Boy, you can see, is very much like Brown Collar. He too is very calm. Nothing fusses him at all. He's just like, okay, that's right, whatever. There can be bombs going off over here and fireworks over here, and there can be sirens. And he'll be just like, oh yeah, oh well, that's just part of life. So he's going to be great with Sydney and Brixton. Those two kids can argue all they want as they get older and as siblings tend to do, and they can have all their friends over and have a great big busy loud household, and Mr. Black will just be thinking, oh, it's all fine, it won't fuss him at all. This little puppy is also very independent. He is very similar to his brother Brown in that way. He is able to think for himself, but he also is very good at understanding what other people are thinking and feeling. Hi, how are you? He knows when it's time to be outgoing and fun and let's go and chase and play, and when it's time just to be a good friend and just to listen and provide some comfort and support. Yes, you do. You do have a kiss for me? Yes, thank you. So he's very similar to Brown. He loves to give kisses. He absolutely adores being snuggled all the time. And outdoors, that's his nirvana. He is such a playful boy. Right now he's showing us that he knows it's time to be calm. And you can see he's licking his nose a bit, because when he kissed me, he got some of my lip gloss and has some of the flavor of it on there. Totally quiet boy, completely calm, and even right now he's chewing on my finger, and even that is a gentle a touch from him. He is an incredibly soft puppy, as we would say, in terms of just being gentle and such a love bug. This is a puppy who's going to thrive on being treated with respect and gentleness. He's willing to do what makes everybody happy, but he will respond best to a very firm voice, but one that's quite calm and quiet. Shouting at him is definitely not going to work with him. So I don't think anyone's planning on shouting at him in any event. While the kids are playing, they can yell at each other. As long as it's not directed at him, that's not going to bother him at all. But this little fellow is going to respond really well to a respectful and great loving relationship with his humans. And Robin, I think he's really going to steal your heart, and probably you are not going to want to even share him with the kids. So that's our little Black Collar boy off to Burnaby with Robin, Stephen, Sydney, and Brixton. There we go. Next, we have our pretty little pink collar girl. And this is our chocolate phantom girl. And pink collar girl is going to be living with Kay and Colin in Victoria as a guardian puppy. This is our keeper as a breeder prospect for Van Isle Labradoodles. Now, why did we choose this little girl? Well, first of all, she's the only girl. So that kind of eliminated everybody else. But regardless of whether everyone else had been a girl, this little muffin would have been our selection. And the reason for that is twofold. One is she matches the breed standard really, really nicely. She has an adorable little face, a nice square head, high set ears, short little nose, and you can see she's a lively little one. She's a bit of a firecracker. She is a lot busier than the two caramel boys. She's much more active and she has a lot more get up and go, so to speak. And that's the kind of thing we're looking for in a mama dog. We don't want a really calm, laid back dog. We want one who's got a little bit fiery so that they have the confidence to be a good mom and that they're really able to handle having multiple little puppies after them when they have their puppies. Now, please don't chew my finger because that's not very good. So this little girl is a chocolate sable. She still looks like a phantom, but she is a sable. So her phantom markings already, you can see, are beginning to disappear in that they're not gone. It's just her coat will all become more one color because she is the sable, which is just exactly the same as her mama Ripple, who's a sable too. Oh yes, she's a sable too. And I think this little puppy is going to be every bit as cute and just a fantastic mama, just like her mama Ripple is. So that's our beautiful pink collar girl, and she has a name already. Her name is Juniper, and she is off with Kay and Colin to live in Victoria. And last but not least, this mini Labradoodle is the one that I was saying might make you raise your eyebrows when we say this is a mini Labradoodle. This fellow is not so tiny or mini. We have called this boy Hefty right from the beginning. And for a while, I was even concerned that he would be able to stand up because he was such a big boy. I wasn't sure if his little puppy legs were going to be able to support him. This puppy, yellow collar, is going to live with Lindsay and Jeff and in Victoria. They were looking for a family dog. They have three kids. And indeed, one of their kids, Lainey's first word was not mama, not dada, a dog. So clearly this is a dog household. So he's going to be a great friend for all three kids to grow up with. He's going to enjoy lots of fun, and they also have a very busy and boisterous household with three children. So they were looking for a dog that would meet all of those requirements. Mr. Yellow is our gentle giant. He is so calm and he's able to remain so no matter what is going on around him. The three boys, actually all of them, even Pink too, are remarkably similar in their temperaments. There really is not a huge difference between any of them. Pink is the one who's a little bit more lively than the other three in terms of she's moves around a bit more. The three boys are so laid back, they're such chill puppies, and just able to handle anything that you throw their way. When we do our desensitization with our Labradoodle puppies, we have lots of things that we throw around and we make faces and we jump up and down and look like complete idiots. And none of these boys have ever raised an eyebrow at our antics. They've just kind of gone, oh, really? Huh? People are pretty strange. Wonder what they're doing that for. But nobody ever was afraid. Nobody ran away. Nobody needed any extra care and attention in order to get over that sort of fear. This little guy is extraordinarily observant. You will see him when we're doing things like that. He'll be sitting there with his head to one side, puzzling over why we're behaving so strangely. If we're doing something, for instance, like taking the recycling out, the first time that happened, he sat and he observed and he watched as Reynolds went into the house, came through the doodle den, packaged things up, took it outside, came back in, and he observed all of that with a great deal of thought. You could just see the wheels turning in his head thinking, huh, wonder what that's all about. When we have hockey or football on the television, although he can't see anything too particularly well, he is always interested in the movements on the screen. And he looks again, he sits, cocks his head, looks, and it's like, I wonder what that's all about. I'm sure he thinks that people are so silly that they do all sorts of goofy things, right? Yeah, I'm sure that's what you're thinking. He's a very well-mannered boy, and he is mature beyond his years already. And this little guy adores children. He is going to be excellent with the kids. Lots of fun, and he's just the right size when you have three kids. When you have three children who are all wanting to play with a puppy and all wanting to have fun with the puppy has to be substantial enough to, in order to withstand that, just physically, never mind what their mental capacity is. Don't eat the microphone, honey. Yes, that's not for you. No, that's too expensive to chew on, okay? Good boy. He's very well behaved, as you can see. He listens and he learns very quickly. This is a very smart puppy. He's going to start trying to train you right away. They all do, but this one in particular will. Yeah, because he knows how to use those big brown eyes, don't you? Mm-hmm, you do. He is going to be, though, with the three kids. Whatever the kids want to do, he'll think is great. You can see that strong, beautiful eye contact he has. So if one of the kids, if Lainey wants to dress him up, oh, he'll be okay with that. He'll put up with that. He'll sit there. He'll wear a costume and he'll pose for the camera. That's just the type of fellow Mr. Yellow Collar is. He's smart. He's playful. But he's also very kind and extraordinarily respectful for a young puppy. So that's Mr. Yellow Collar. Off to Lindsay and Jeff and kids in Victoria. And that's all the puppies for this litter. So that was a really quick video. Everyone now knows where their puppies are going. I hope you're all delighted with the selections we've made for you. I think that we have had some really great matches here with these puppies. They just all seem to fall into place. It would have been easy to give any of them to any of you because they are all so similar. Mr. Hefty, I can't wait to find out his name, plus black and brown. Really interested to know what everybody is going to name their puppies. And because all of you are in our Head Start program, as soon as you tell us their names, we will start using their names so they become more accustomed to them. Juniper, who we also call Junebug, has known her name for quite a while, so she already knows hers. The other guys all know Puppy, so now let's get those names chosen so we can start using them. So congratulations, everybody. We hope you love your new mini Labradoodle from Van Isle Doodles.